Hey, what's going on, YouTube viewers? Right now, you can see I'm playing Grand Theft Auto 4, The Lost and the Damned. I actually like this DLC because it's pretty much based off a biker, based off of bikers or whatever, you know what I mean? There's a lot of story to this. But the real reason I made this video is to talk about GTA 5. Yeah, so I want to talk about GTA 5, and before I get into the GTA 5 thing, I'm a big Grand Theft Auto fan. I played all the Grand Theft Auto games. I'm a huge Grand Theft Auto fan, you know what I mean? GTA is probably my favorite game of all time. It's a great fucking game. They came out with a gameplay trailer about a week ago or whatever. Everybody and their mama has been putting up, re-uploading gameplay trailers and everything to get views, you know what I mean? But I really want to talk about, will GTA 5 be good? And it seems like a lot of people have forgot how great a game GTA is, how great of a company Rockstar is, and they've been kind of like, you know, overlooked. Like, people forgot about them. Like, everybody is into this bullshit Saint Rose shit, man. Like, everybody loves Saint Rose. People say Saint Rose is the next Grand Theft Auto. People are so hyped over Watch Dogs. They came out with a bullshit game, Sleeping Dogs. All these games they came out, all these bullshit imitation Grand Theft Auto games they came out with, and they're all fucking bullshit, man. GTA is by far and always will be the greatest sandbox game ever made. It just is, man. They're the ones that revolutionized the sandbox game, man. People just forget about GTA, man. I don't understand how people forget and these stupid imitations get praised, man. How the fuck do people like St. Rose and they say Grand Theft Auto is whack? I don't get that, but I hear some people say that they like St. Rose over Grand Theft Auto because I guess you could, you know, I guess it's maybe co-op or some shit. Or co-op multiplayer or some shit like that, you know what I mean? But right now I have some footage of GTA 5. I heard some information about this game, and this game looks like it's gonna be sick, man. It's like you get three characters, you get Michael, you get Trevor, and you get some other dude, either Michael, Trevor, who's the other guy? I don't know, some other dude, I don't know his name right now, but you get some other guy, man, and you get three characters or whatever, and three characters with three different backgrounds, three different upbringings. They live in three different areas of San Andreas, and this game's gonna be in California. They're a fake California of San Andreas or whatever, you know what I mean? So if it's, this game looks pretty massive. If it's anything like Grand Theft Auto San Andreas? Grand Theft Auto San Andreas to me is the greatest game ever fucking made. Point blank period. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas is probably up there with my top 5 games. And if this game already looks like it's way better than Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, man. Come on, man, yeah. Three characters, you can switch between three characters. When you go on a mission, you can pretty much pick how you execute the mission, what characters do what, you're switching between characters. It's not like in every Grand Theft Auto game, you get a mission, you have to do how, you have to pretty much go by the mission, you know, whatever the mission wants you to do, you have to do it that way. You can do the mission wherever the fuck you want to do. You don't have to, you can go into a bank and blow everybody's heads off. You can sneak into the bank. You can do so much other stuff to pull off heists, pull off kills. It's just, this game looks fucking sick, man. There's so much stuff you can do. You can looks like you can get tattoos, you can swim, you can bowl, you can work out. This game looks fucking crazy, man. It's definitely gonna be the game of the year. That's why I said I don't understand like how people I talk to before this trailer came out. But right now everybody is pretty much, you know, going crazy with this game. They can't wait for the game to come out. But before this trailer came out, I was pretty much hyped on Grand Theft Auto anyway. But people were saying that, oh man, Grand Theft Auto is dead. It's the same shit. It's pretty much the same shit. It's gonna be same stuff. You do missions, blah blah blah, boring. How is Grand Theft Auto boring, man? How is this game boring? This is one of the best fucking games fucking ever made, man. Best games ever fucking made. But, you know, let me talk about the multiplayer. I hear rumors, and it's just rumors, not confirmed rumors, but the multiplayer is going to be like one kind of one big massive MMO. Like, it's going to be a whole bunch of people in one like city or whatever. I don't know the proof. I just heard rumors, but pretty much it's going to be like a whole bunch of people in one, like maybe 25, 30 people in one game or some shit, playing Anarchy, all that shit, man. The only one thing, the one gripe I have about the trailer is that there's no co-op, man. It would have been cool to have like a three-player co-op or whatever, you know what I mean, in this. But I mean, the game is still fucking crazy, man. The game is still fucking crazy. I am gonna pre-order this game, but I thought about maybe going to a mom and pop shop, getting the game a week early, and uploading it. I probably will get a copyright strike. I might just make a separate account to upload the GTA 5 a week before it comes out. I might make an account because I know I'll probably get some type of strikes. I'll probably get my account banned and whatever, you know what I mean? But I want to get a game early and put up gameplay early, you know what I mean? Grant, GTA 5 is one of my favorite games of all time, even though I like Halo. Before Halo, there was always GTA. GTA is one of these games I can play over and over again. I'll probably beat GTA 4 about maybe like, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 times, man. I'm not really into the multiplayer of GTA 4. I just love the campaign. I like playing the campaign. I like doing the missions. That's what I do. That's what I like. But GTA 5, in my prediction, will be game of the year. Guaranteed. It will be game of the year. What else can I talk about GTA 5 that I've heard of, man? I mean, I guess once you finish missions or whatever, I guess you can, like, with the three characters you have, I guess you can go between each character that they're doing at the time. But there's one thing I wanted to know. If you have three characters, right, and when the mission's over, you go and see what they're doing, how would that, like, work into the story? Would they have some random stuff happening? Or like they get into random shootouts, or they get into random heists. Weird. Can you go on a heist by yourself? It's weird. But we will find out when the game comes out. So that's my video, guys. I'm playing GTA right now, as you can see. This is the greatest chase in history. I'm trying to get away from the police. it was pretty. This mission was pretty hard, man. Cause I think I had to switch through 2 or 3 different cars to get away from these fucking cops, man. But yo, that's my video, guys. GTA 5 will be the game of the year. I will try to get it a week early. I will try to upload it on YouTube. I will give you guys details on what channel I'm going to upload it to. So that's my video, guys. Rate, comment, subscribe, all that good shit. And I'm out. See you guys later.